गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टडी क्लास 9th चैप्टर 14, दैट इज नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज. एज द नेम इंडिकेट नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज, विच मीन्स द रिसोर्सेज विच वी गेट फ्रॉम नेचर आर कॉल्ड नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज. सो हियर वी लिव ऑन अ प्लैनेट अर्थ, दैट इज The earth is the only planet on which the life exists. So on the life on earth, so there are number of factors that are responsible for the existence of life. So we need many things such as ambient temperature, water and food. These are the main resources which we needed. So here we have to know the resources available on the earth, and the energy from the sun are the necessary to meet the basic requirement all form on the earth. So which means sun and resources of the earth are very important to meet with the basic requirements. So here you can note down that the sun is the necessary and the earth resources are the basic requirements. Next is what are these resources on the earth? There is land, water and air on the earth. So the outer crust of the earth is called lithosphere. So here 75% of water cover on the earth's surface. So all the water that we need are present on the are found in the underground. So here we can say that all the water are present in the underground. So here the water which is present are comprised the hydrosphere. So the air that cover the whole the earth like a blanket, so it is called atmosphere. So what is atmosphere? The air that cover the whole earth like a blanket is called atmosphere. So living things are found where these three exist, means where water, air are present, land, water and air is present, then the living things exist. So life supporting zone of earth where the atmosphere, the hydrosphere and lithosphere interact, that is called biosphere. So here the point to be noted, what is biosphere? So the biosphere is the atmosphere, hydrosphere and the lithosphere interact and make life possible. So living things constitute the basic component of the biosphere. The air, water and soil form the non-living or the abiotic component of the biosphere. So mainly what are the biotic component? That is living things are the biotic component. Clear? So what are the non-biotic component? The air, water and soil form the abiotic component of the biosphere. So next we will study about role in sustaining the life on earth. So land, water, air are the most important component for the survival of life. So the next is the breath of life, that is air. So we already know the air is necessary for living. So the composition of the air we already studied. So it is mixture of the gases like nitrogen, oxygen, carbon and water vapors. It is interesting to note that even the composition of the air is the result of life on earth. So other planets such as Venus, Mars has no life. So the major component is atmosphere. The major component of the atmosphere found to be carbon dioxide. So where the life is not exist, where? Because there is no atmosphere. Is that clear? So in fact, the carbon dioxide is 95 to 97% of atmosphere in Venus and Mars. So we had studied about eukaryotic and prokaryotic cells in chapter 5, that is cell. So they need oxygen to break down the glucose. So in this way, this result in the production of carbon dioxide. So another process which result in consumption of oxygen and the concomitant production of carbon dioxide is combustion. So this include not just a human activity, but other activities also, like burning of fuels or forest fires also produce the carbon dioxide. So the percentage of the carbon dioxide in atmosphere is increasing, but their fraction of percentage is fixed. So how it is fixed? So here you can see our atmosphere is a mixture, mere fraction of percentage because of carbon dioxide in two ways. That is, number one, green plant convert carbon dioxide into glucose in the presence of sunlight, and many marine animals use carbonate dissolved salt in seawater. So in this way we can say that percentage of carbon dioxide, mere fraction of percentage. So here is all about the air, so which contain mainly the two components, it is oxygen and carbon dioxide, and other gases, nitrogen also. So next is the role of atmosphere in climate control. So how atmosphere control the climate? So we know atmosphere is the covering around the earth like a blanket of air. So mainly air is bad conductor of heat. The atmosphere keep the average temperature of the earth fairly steady during the day, even during the course of whole year. So atmosphere prevent the sudden increase in temperature during daylight hours. So mainly what is the purpose of atmosphere? It prevent the sudden increase, and during night it slow down the escape of heat into outer space. Moon is same distance from sun, that is the earth is. So there is no surface of on the moon. Why there is no surface? It is the only reason of having no surface, because there is no atmosphere and the temperature range is -190 degrees to 110, which means there is no atmosphere and the temperature range is much higher. So here, so we can see that the next, in next topic, we can see, you can see that activity at home. So here, the movement of air wind. So how air move? So movement of air is called wind. What is wind? That is movement of air. So we feel cool evening breeze after a hot day, and sometime we will get a rain also after a hot weather. So how, what is the main cause of movement of air and what decided its movement? So here all the phenomena that take place in our atmosphere is during heating of air and formation of water vapor. So how the air produces, that is a result of changes take place in atmosphere due to heating and formation of water vapors. So water vapors formed due to the heating of water bodies and the activities of living organism. The atmosphere can be heated from below by the radiation that is reflected back or re-radiated by the land. So why and how atmosphere can be heated? Because when the rays are reflected or re-radiated. On being heated, conventional current set up in the air. So in this way, we can understand what is the convection current. So here it is the activity you can do. You can see here, we burn a candle in a beaker. So in a beaker, the light and incense stick, and we will take it in near the mouth of the beaker. Which way does the smoke flow when the increased stick is near the edge? You can see the smoke flow towards the incense stick. So here the pattern reveal that the smoke show the direction in which the hot and cold airs are moving. So in similar way, we can calculate how the radiation air is moving from land or water. So land get heated faster, the air over land would heat it faster than the air over water bodies. So if you look the situation in coastal region during day, so you can see here the situation in coastal region during day, the air above the land gets heated faster and start rising. So here as a result, air rises and region of low pressure is created and air over the sea moves into area of low pressure. The movement of air from one region to other creates wind. On the other side, during the day, the direction of the wind would be from sea to land. So mainly here is a point to be noted that the movement of air from one region to another creates wind. On the other side, at the night, the land and sea start to cool. Since water cool down and slower than land, and the air above water would be warmer than the air above land. So here you can note that point. So above discussion, the appearance of areas of low and high pressure in coastal areas at night and the direction of the air in the coastal areas during night. All the movement of air, so here is diverse phenomena, are caused by uneven heating of atmosphere. So there is a various factor that influences these winds. So rotation of the earth, presence of mountains, winds are a couples of these factors. So mainly the factor is rotation of earth and the presence of mountain region in the path of winds. So these are the couple of regions. So why wind is moving? So Himalaya change the flow of wind blowing from Allahabad toward the north. So in this way we can say that the changing the speed can also change the speed of the wind, or direction of the wind can also change the weather of the area. So next is rain. Let us go now to the question, how clouds are formed and bring rain. So next question is, how clouds are formed? So you can see here, how clouds are formed is the next question. So here, the formation of cloud can be understood with this activity. But before going to this activity, we will see here. Take an empty bottle of salt, which bottled water is sold. Take an empty bottle, add 5 to 10 ml water and close it, shake it well and place it in the sun for 10 minutes. You can see the water vapors are seeing in the bottle. So take an incense stick and open the cap of the bottle and allow some of the smoke from the incense stick to enter the bottle. Then close the bottle and make sure cap is tight. Press the bottle hard between your hand and crush it as possible. Wait for a second and again press the bottle as hard as you can. So above experiment replicates on a very small scale what happened when the air with high content of water vapor goes from region of high pressure to low pressure or low pressure to high pressure. So here the answer is, when the water bodies are heated during day, the large amount of water evaporates and goes into air. Some amount of water vapor also get in the atmosphere because of biological activity. This air also gets heated and hot air rises up carrying the water vapor with it. As a result, air rises and expands, cools. So this cooling causes the water vapor in the air and condense in the form of tiny droplets. So this condensation of water facilitate if some particles could act as nucleus for these drop to form around, and the normal dust and other suspended particle in the air perform this function. So here we can say that on the water droplets are formed and the condensation of these water droplets. So when the drops have grown, the big heavy and they fall down in the form of rain. So here we can see mainly when the water evaporates and go into atmosphere, the air also heated and the hot rays carrying these water vapor. So as a result, air rises, expands and cool. So cooling causes water vapor in the air to condense and form tiny droplets. So these tiny droplets also contain the dust and other particles. So water droplets are formed and they grow bigger, bigger. So by condensation of these, they fall down. So sometimes when the temperature of the air is low enough, precipitation may occur in the form of snow and sleet or hail. So rainfall patterns are decided by the prevailing wind pattern. In large part of India, rain are mostly brought through south, west, north, east mountain. So we also heard about weather report that caused depression in Bay of Bengal may cause the rain in some areas. So here you can see the areas where you can see the different types of rains are formed. So here we had completed the main biotic and abiotic component of the atmosphere, how clouds are formed, how rain is produced, how wind is moving, how air is moving. These are certain factors which are related to our natural resources. So in next lecture, we will deal with the next topic, that is air pollution. So till then, you can revise your previous chapters, because as the tests are going continuously after the completion of the chapter. So be prepared for the chapter so that you can improve your marks in final term examination. Thank you.